everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another spherical coordinates problem today. And the coordinates that we're given are 2, pi over 3, 3 pi over 2. And we're going to be taking these spherical coordinates and converting them into rectangular or Cartesian coordinates. So a couple things to remember here. The spherical coordinates come in the form rho, phi, or phi, theta. And we're going to be using these three formulas here to find x, y, and z of our Cartesian or rectangular coordinates. So really, as long as we can remember that our spherical coordinates are in this order here, rho, phi, and theta, and if we can remember these three formulas, and we, I guess, know how to use the unit circle, we should be home free with this kind of a problem. So the first thing that we'll do is plug in 2 for rho, pi over 3 for phi, and 3 pi over 2 for theta, everywhere where those variables occur in these formulas. And what we'll get are the following three formulas for x, y, and z. Notice here that we plugged in 2 for rho, pi over 3 for phi, and 3 pi over 2 for theta here, which gives us our x equation, our y equation, and our z equation. And if we just simplify the three of these, we'll get our Cartesian or rectangular coordinate. So in order to evaluate these three equations, or simplify them, we'll need to use our unit circle. Notice that we only have a couple different angles here. We're going to be looking for sine and cosine at the angle pi over 3. That occurs in all three of our equations for x, y, and z. And we're also going to be looking at 3 pi over 2. So let's jump over here to our unit circle and look for those two angles. Remember, the first one we're looking at is pi over 3. So we find pi over 3 along our unit circle, and at this angle, we are looking for both cosine and sine. Remember that when you're using the unit circle, if you're asked to find cosine of an angle, you'll be looking at the x-coordinate there. If you're asked to find sine of an angle, you'll be looking at the y-coordinate there. So cosine of pi over 3 is 1/2, and sine of pi over 3 is the square root of 3 over 2. So we'll keep those two values in mind. And then we're also going to be looking at the angle 3 pi over 2. So if we continue along our unit circle here and we find 3 pi over 2, here's the angle, we're going to need cosine and sine of that angle. So again, cosine of this angle will be 0, the x-coordinate, and sine of this angle will be negative 1, the y-coordinate. So given those four values, let's head back over here to our equations. If we bring in the values that we found in our unit circle, sine of pi over 3, or the y-coordinate where the angle is equal to pi over 3, is the square root of 3 over 2. Cosine of 3 pi over 2, or the x-coordinate where the angle is equal to 3 pi over 2, is 0. So when we multiply 2 by the square root of 3 over 2 by 0, of course we get 0. For y, we're looking at the y-coordinate where the angle is equal to pi over 3, which is the square root of 3 over 2. We're looking at the y-coordinate where the angle is equal to 3 pi over 2, and that is negative 1, both of these values getting pulled from our unit circle. So when we multiply those together, the 2's will cancel, because this is in the numerator and this is the denominator, and we're left with simply negative square root of 3. Looking at our z equation here, we will substitute 1/2, because that is where, that's the x-coordinate where the angle is equal to pi over 3, 1/2. So then we multiply 1/2 by 2, and we get 1. So that's all we have to do to simplify our equations, and to find our final answer, we combine all three of these x, y, and z, and we get 0, negative square root of 3, 1, as our rectangular or Cartesian coordinate, and this is exactly equal to the spherical coordinate 2 pi over 3, 3 pi over 2. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!